Our planet is facing many serious environmental problems. These problems include global warming, loss of biodiversity, tropical deforestation, ocean plastic waste, and water and air pollution. Global environmental problems are often called wicked problems because they are highly complex, difficult to define, and may affect regions and groups differently. Also, they are typically difficult to predict and involve various people, including those who caused the problem and those who are affected by the problem. There are no clear-cut solutions to environmental problems. In order to effectively deal with these problems, it is necessary for all people involved in these problems to work, think, and act together to solve them. Groups of people involved in environmental problems are also referred to as stakeholders. In many cases, it is used to refer to people who are involved from a different standpoint than the organization or group that is leading a project. For example, when a company is developing a management strategy, the potential users of the company's products may be called as stakeholders. When a researcher is conducting a research, stakeholders can be those who are interested in the research topic or live in the area being studied, such as residents, government officials, or NGO officials. Knowledge co-creation, in which researchers and stakeholders work together to solve problems and create new knowledge, is academically known as transdisciplinary research. Scientific data and knowledge are essential in solving environmental problems. For example, to correctly understand the current situation, to clarify cause and effect relationships, and to predict future changes. However, there are many solutions proposed by researchers that are actually never realized in society. Transdisciplinarity therefore aims to produce practical results that can be realized in society. It is a type of collaborative research in which researchers work together with stakeholders to come up with solutions. Other research methods that span multiple disciplines include multidisciplinarity and interdisciplinarity. In multidisciplinarity, researchers from multiple disciplines work on a common topic while maintaining independence between disciplines. In interdisciplinarity, researchers from multiple disciplines conduct research on a common research subject in collaboration with each other. The core characteristic of interdisciplinary research is their goal to integrate concepts, methods, and principles from different disciplines. In contrast, transdisciplinarity is characterized by strong collaboration between not only researchers from multiple disciplines, but also non-academic societal stakeholders in order to solve societal problems. Transdisciplinarity research aims to combine different types of knowledge and expertise to create new knowledge and more effective solutions that cannot be conceived by any one individual discipline. Transdisciplinary research has a history of more than 50 years and was first proposed in the 1970s. In the late 1930s, interdisciplinarity was being promoted and many universities around the world opened departments that combined different disciplines, such as environmental studies and women's studies. To improve academia's role in addressing societal problems, the concept of transdisciplinarity was proposed to further advance interdisciplinarity by breaking down barriers, not only between disciplines, but also between academia and society, as well as to promote integration of academic and non-academic knowledge. There are two major schools of thought on transdisciplinarity. One is to emphasize the integration of knowledge from various disciplines. The other is to focus on collaboration between researchers and stakeholders in the real world. The abbreviation TD is also often used to refer to transdisciplinarity. Transdisciplinary research is called TD research. There are some tips for successful TD research. For example, the right people should be involved. Trust should be built among the participants, and participants should aim to learn from each other. To put this into practice, it is recommended that a three-step process is employed in transdisciplinary research. The first stage is called co-design, or collaborative planning. The appropriate people are brought together to form a team, identify common issues, and work together to plan the project. The second phase is called co-production, or collaborative knowledge production. In this stage, new knowledge is generated by collecting and analyzing data and discussing the results together. The third step is reflection and dissemination. Trial and error is inevitable for any new initiative. It is therefore important to reflect on the process, correct what did not work, and plan the next steps. The results are then compiled and disseminated. In this stage, it is important to produce outputs that are useful for both academia and society. For academia, the results can be published in the form of academic papers, while for society, outputs can include policy proposals, community development plans, new business initiatives, or establishment of nonprofit organizations. The results are thus expected to be utilized in both academia and society. Academic progress will be made in disseminating the findings to the academic community, for example, through academic papers or conferences, so it can lead to new research questions. In society, the proposed solutions are hopefully implemented to solve environmental problems, for instance, through implementation of policies or action plans. If some issues remain unsolved, they can then be addressed in a new TD research. In this way, the TD research process involves societal stakeholders and researchers working closely together throughout the stages of planning, production, and dissemination to address common issues facing society and science. A single initiative may not be enough to change society at large. However, TD projects have shown to lead to positive changes in the awareness, knowledge, attitudes, and behavior of groups that participate in them. They also often lead to new initiatives and participants sharing the knowledge gained with others. Some of these changes may be small at first, but gradually they can spread throughout society. Transdisciplinary research can inspire continuous efforts and new partnerships to address global environmental problems, which are difficult to solve and becoming more and more serious. Let us work and collaborate together using the transdisciplinary approach for a better and more sustainable future.